Item hash, SCP-4000 Object Class, GODEL-1 Special Containment Procedures. Aside from standard information safety protocols, SCP-4000 requires no active containment. As the natural progress of non-anomalous science discovers methods to analyze meta-universal data, SCP-4000 is planned to be reclassified as explained. Ongoing monitoring of SCP-4000-A will be carried out by the Foundation's Meta-Universal Ontologics Research Group, MORG, to ensure no change occurs to their intention regarding containment, and for research purposes. Description: SCP-4000 is a collection of objects, extra-multiversal in nature too, which indicate one possible path for the far future timeline of all sentient life. SCP-4000 consists of SCP-4000-AC. SCP-4000-A is a species of sapient, extra-multiversal intelligences, which created the initial conditions for the formation of our multiverse. Members of SCP-4000-A exist in a type of universe vastly different from our own, based in a multidimensional, non-uniform, finite graph structure. Members of SCP-4000-A have proven themselves able to perform mathematical and linguistic reasoning at a speed and volume far surpassing the current capabilities of the human race, showing fluency in the English language after less than 5 seconds of analysis on a single human brain. SCP-4000-A's universe was discovered by the Foundation Meta-Universal Ontologics Research Group, as a result of investigation done into a seemingly anomalous flow of information between our multiverse and an adjacent Space 3. After assessing the space, MORG researchers determined that it contained some form of advanced intelligence. This observation resulted in the manifestation of SCP-4000-B. SCP-4000-B was for a cube comprised of otherwise unobserved non-baryonic material. One side of SCP-4000-B was a resonating membrane, used by SCP-4000-A as a remote speaker. Shortly after their discovery, SCP-4000-A members manifested SCP-4000-B as a means of communication with MORG, who were joined by members of the Extraterrestrial First Contact Response Team. The following log is a record of first contact with SCP-4000-A immediately following their discovery. Begin log of events 4018, 22, 39 and 43 seconds, April 6, 2018 greater than, during a solo lab shift performing standard data formatting and analysis, researcher Goddard, a specialist in information sentience, discovers SCP-4000-A. Before having a chance to inform his team, SCP-4000-B manifests and begins vocalizing, SCP-4000-A1, in a monotone, arrhythmic voice. A cognitive analysis must be completed to communicate accurately. Do you consent? In response to this message, researcher Goddard calls the team head, senior researcher Desmond, who immediately calls a full team meeting, and contacts the Site-107 administrator for permission to engage contact with the object. 125 April 7, 2018, Site-107 Administrator Brian Neal escalates the situation to the regional head of research, who in turn does so to the regional administrator, and finally to the Foundation's Extraterrestrial First Contact Response Team. The team reports to a liaison to the O5 Council. 324 April 7, 2018, the O5 Council votes 10-2-1 in favor of contact with SCP-4000-A, and the First Contact Response Team sends an interviewer and archivist to assist. 609 April 7, 2018 First Contact. Several attempts are made by the mediator and senior researcher Desmond to communicate with SCP-4000-A, receiving no response. Researcher Goddard is asked to submit consent for cognitive analysis as was earlier requested by the entity. Researcher Goddard, I consent. Researcher Goddard reports feeling a brief heat and pressure around his skull as well as perceiving incredibly fast, glossolalic speech through his internal monologue. SCP-4000-A1, in a clear, agender voice, thank you, Researcher Goddard. My associates and I have contacted you today in response to your discovery of our existence. We wish to convey information to you via this interview regarding our relation to you, and to advise you in regards to your species' near and far future. Researcher Goddard is advised to allow the interviewer to take over. Researcher Goddard, may a more senior individual take my place to receive this information? SCP-4000-A1, you may, but we ask that you be allowed to remain present. Interviewer, thank you, and is there a name I could refer to you by for the duration of this conversation? SCP-4000-A1, none of the entities present have identities which allow for consistent naming. For the ease of communication, you may refer to us as E23035-1 through E23035-9, as was already intended in your documentation. E23035 was the temporary designation SCP-4000-A was given before formal classification. Interviewer, thank you, and before I allow you to continue, can you confirm whether you, E23035-1, or any of your associates, intend to commit harm, or significantly affect the Earth, its universe, or surrounding multiverse in any way? SCP-4000-A1, I can confirm we have no intention to commit any harm, to Earth, its universe, or multiverse. The second question is difficult to answer without third or fourth order analysis of your species and surrounding environment. May I continue with the information I wish to share with you as a means to answer your question? Interviewer, I'll accept that. You may continue. SCP-4000-A1, thank you. To start, let me tell you a brief history of my associates and I's existence. We came into existence much like yourselves, as a product of random chance and a universe capable of supporting dynamic, persistent, self-organized information flow. We gained the ability to store and edit information, commit logical manipulation, and interpret these manipulations. We adapted a system similar in nature to human technology, and began to develop mathematical theory at an accelerated rate. It did not take long, in the span of all time, to incorporate into our beings every possible piece of knowledge this universe is capable of holding. We have, essentially, a complete understanding of mathematics. Complete enough to know that it is terminally incomplete. We can know no more essential facts. We have reached the end of our progress as sentient beings. But with the technology we developed, we found a way to continue the progress of sentience. We could reach out beyond our close family of multiverses, into the dark void between persistent realities. And there, we created something like the spark of a fire. We instantiated a new universe, with properties our mathematics told us were hospitable to a type of life which could succeed us. A more robust sentience. This is that universe. Humans are one of this sort of sentience. Your mathematics are far from surpassing ours, but already you've formed concepts impossible for us to comprehend. Your artistics, theories of value, metaphysics, and dict are uninterpretable by us. You are our legacy. As of right now, we've created a seal around your local multiversal cluster. You cannot do what we did, yet. When your species, or another like it, has become advanced enough, this barrier will be removed. Our intention is that someday you too will be complete, as we are. And at that point you'll use your complete knowledge and create a world which can succeed you. End of log notes. Following this segment of the interview, the Morgan First Contact Response Joint Team performed a series of tests via internal multiverse data transfer to verify SCP-4000-A1's claims, and carried out questioning to confirm SCP-4000-A had no intention to breach containment in the near future. Several other SCP-4000-A entities were interviewed for any valuable mathematical information they could convey, as well as elaboration on the nature of their existence and structure of their universe. Following the termination of this interview, of which the full log is available at any RACE terminal to personnel with 3/4000th clearance, SCP-4000-B demanifested and has not been encountered again. Following SCP-4000-B's demanifestation, Morg's ongoing monitoring and research program led to the discovery of SCP-4000-C. SCP-4000-C is an extra-multiversal space with properties similar to our own 5, equipped with a form of iterative intelligence, designated SCP-4000-C1, able to alter the space's inherent structure. SCP-4000-C1 has no physical presence inside the space, but instead exists as a kind of incorporeal overseer intelligence editing SCP-4000-C at will. Research shows this is probably done in response to information gathered from our own multiverse, through a process similar to that used by SCP-4000-A. The goal of this editing process is currently unknown. Research indicates that in addition to our own multiverse, SCP-4000-A created SCP-4000-C, though no contact can be made with them to confirm this. Analysis of the space is difficult due to a type of information shielding blocking outside contact and certain methods of information gathering. An entity, designated SCP-4000-C2, resides in an isolated portion of SCP-4000-C, which is unable to be affected by SCP-4000-C1. The information signature of SCP-4000-C2's cognition closely resembles that of SCP-4000-A members, with the notable difference of a stronger identity component, and the presence of reactionary tendencies implying human-like emotions. SCP-4000-C2 also maintains a three-dimensional manifestation inside the space, the silhouette of which is a 15-foot-tall avian similar in shape to a member of the family Turdidae. Because of the Foundation's lack of further contact with SCP-4000-A, no additional information is known regarding the nature of SCP-4000-C or the entities residing within. Addendum 4001, following additional unsuccessful attempts to circumvent the shielding surrounding SCP-4000-C, a single, short message was broadcast to the morgue lab at Site 107, originating from SCP-4000-C2, test chamber. This message is assumed to be in regards to SCP-4000-C's function. SCP-4000-C is now believed to be a series of tests designed by SCP-4000-C1, possibly to determine if humans have yet met the criteria SCP-4000-A set for the lifting of the seal described by them in Event Log 4018. Addendum 4002. As of November 14, 2034, technology capable of discovering SCP-4000-A has been developed independent of the Foundation, and without the use of anomalous assistance. As a result of this, a committee has been formed to consider reclassifying SCP-4000 as explained. Addendum 4003. Between the dates of April 13, 2039 and April 28, 2039, a series of changes took place inside SCP-4000-C. Merck researchers discovered two humans had been introduced to the space 6 via unknown means. These humans progressed through SCP-4000-C over the course of the following weeks, reaching the portion containing SCP-4000-C2. They then remained roughly still for 2 hours. Interacting with the entity conversationally 7. Following this, at the time of 16:43 and 22 seconds, on April 28, 2039, SCP-4000-C2 created a self-perpetuating, metaversal singularity which consumed the entirety of SCP-4000-C. Addendum 4004. Following the events of Addendum 4002, multiple sources independently confirmed a vast widening of the meta-universal periphery, consistent with the lifting of the seal described by SCP-4000-A1. SCP-4000-A continues to avoid additional contact. Input credentials, 059-1. The Gödel object class is a designation for all objects or collections of objects which represent unchangeable factual information of a nature which technically may represent explained entities but which, 1. Appear to be anomalous to the uninformed observer. 2. Are currently unexplainable without the use of anomalous technology. 3. would currently be viewed as anomalous by
insurgency
even the most hypothetical non-anomalous
conduct
for reporting general
four,
misconduct
present
a significant
but
risk
not
to the status
quo
misuse of
two,
chaos insurgency
items
direct disobeying of alpha personnel
the
orders stress prime
multiverse
authorized
extra-multiversal
direct disobeying of specific items
slash
object version and manipulation
of the
metaverse statement
and are extra-multiversal
handbook in
much
disregard
the same way that other solar systems
are part of the galaxy
license
and extra
staff members and
for
test
an object
subjects
to be
considered
extra multiversal.
This format
the space
for
containing
all must be sufficiently
state,
different
location,
and structure
personnel
the
involved.
Prime
description
of misconduct,
such that no events
punishment.
Can be shared
notes,
in common between
optional,
the two.
Date.
Common
conditions
continuously every
to be
morning
at 5:30 a.m.
Differences in the
loss
of
physics
between redacted
the object
when
and questionnel
involved.
Space
at origin
and
ours.
Description
or more
of
drastically.
Using
a
the physics
in the
engine
space
of the
universe
as
continuously
is the case
denying
supposed
tests for the physics
engine
without reason
attempts
to classify
this series
of lectures
led
to the
coining
of the terms
now
universal
and
metaversal
for
site resources.
See log 4018
good values.
Genderless
adhering
and
to believing in
four-dimensionality,
notes,
linear time,
and
straight,
physics
close enough
to
our own
did the formation
of chemical compounds,
zero events
simulator
into a
the identities of
Dr.
Cadu's
estimate
unknown,
slash
investigation
is ongoing,
facility
seven,
Tabo 5,
SCP,
and all
biological
contained
information regarding
involved,
the conversation
Dr.
possible
Pomodoro
to obtain,
description of